Workers across Asia hold May Day rallies to call for the protection of labor rights. Thousands of South Korean workers gathered in Seoul to stage a large-scale protest criticizing the government's labor policies. They say workers' rights have significantly regressed since President Yoon Suk-yeol took office. The organizers said about 25,000 workers attended that rally. In Istanbul, scuffles break out as protesters try to reach the central Taksim Square in defiance of a government ban. The Turkish government has long declared the square off limits for rallies after a 1977 May Day celebration was marred by a shooting and stampede that killed 34 people. At least 30 members of a left-wing party who tried to break through police barriers were arrested. And in China, a five-day Labor Day holiday has kicked off. Domestic tourism, the world's second-largest economy, showing signs of post-pandemic recovery. That's as locals opt to take domestic vacations rather than overseas travel amid lingering concerns over economic uncertainties.
Here at home, Labor Day protesters clashed with police after they were stopped from holding a demonstration outside the U.S. Embassy in Manila. Authorities had to use water cannons to keep the protesters from getting past a barricade. Six people were arrested. The rally later continued a few meters away with the protesters calling for wage hikes.
Unang kailangan gawin ng pamahalaan, certify as urgent yung proposal for wage increase. Pangalawa, support for Filipino entrepreneurs, Filipino farmers sa panahon ng El Nino lalo na. National industrialization na nakaasa sa ating sariling kakayahan.
Similar protest actions were also held in the provinces of Pampanga and Cebu, with over 100 members of different labor groups participating. Meanwhile, motorcycle taxi drivers and delivery riders marked Labor Day with a strike. The Coalition of Union Courier and Shipper Services Philippines says 80% of their members refused to book clients in Metro Manila Wednesday. The group is up in arms over the high commission rates being deducted from their earnings by ride-hailing and delivery service apps. Some riders also joined the bigger rally of workers and transport groups in Manila.
Philippine Energy Regulatory Commission planning to suspend the operations of the wholesale electricity spot market during red alert notices. President Marcos Jr. says the move is meant to ease the burden of consumers amid rising prices of electricity. During the WESM suspension, the administered price imposed by market operators will apply. The WESM is a centralized venue for buyers and sellers to trade electricity as a commodity. Prices are usually determined based on demand and supply.
Dahil sa matinding init, tumataas ang konsumo ng kuryente na nakakadagdag sa pag-akyat ng presyo. Ito ay naglalayo na pigilan ang pagtaas ng presyo ng kuryente sa gitna ng kalamidad na dulot ng El Nino. Sa mga susunod na araw, ay magpapaabot tayo ng tulong pinansyal sa mga lubhang naapektuhan ng El Nino sa buong bansa.